If your hand hurts and it hurts real bad, or if you have feelings that are making you sad, then it's okay to cry.
Donald J. Trump is now President of the United States.
What a great honor to be able to introduce for the first time ever anywhere the 45th President of the United States of America, Donald.
I am so sorry to my world. I am so sorry to my world. This is not going on.
We will face challenges.
So much potential. For beauty and for devastation. In this one moment, it's almost incomprehensible that they can exist right now. So.
And we are grateful.
So
for President Obama.
Get your abortions now. Because we're going to be fucked and we're going to have to live with it.
You're awake, by the way. You're not having a terrible, terrible dream. Also, you're not dead and you haven't gone to hell. This is your life now. This is our election now. This is us. This is our country.
This is a different earth today than it was 24 hours ago. It's
a kind of pushback against the advancement of African Americans, of Hispanics, of women, of Muslim Americans.
The prevalent feeling was that she was the lesser of two evils. And America is still wet and voted for the worst of two evils. And so the message that sends is that no matter what, if you are a woman, you're not good enough. Because if she was the lesser of two evils, then she still loses. Why? The message it sends is that you can work for 40 years and you can be the most qualified candidate for something and you can be the most deserving candidate and you still won't be as good.
You can judge me.
Well, not really, negative.
So if Donald Trump is democratically elected and your son is serving as a Marine, you wouldn't trust his life under that commander-in-chief, and Kane said...
Feels like the end of the world.
On Lifetime last night, and I was slowly getting drunk is what happened to me.
How do we explain how this is possible?
How did this happen?
Well, colleges across the country try to console millennials having temper tantrums after Donald Trump's historic victory. They are canceling tests, giving out free hot chocolate, offering therapy dogs, and free passes to skip class to those students who are just so upset. They're also giving crayons and Play-Doh, which is something I get in my Bible.
It is a mourning moment for those people, and it is a moment filled with fear.
I knew that I had to support him tonight, because I knew hasn't really hit yet, that Trump is going to be the president for the next 4 years. And I'm so fucking scared.
Even if you don't like her, she's qualified. And we end up with Donald Trump? Are you?
Is there a doomsday plan for a time like this?
Am I right to ask about a doomsday plan? Do you see this as a doomsday scenario?
Oh, man, come on, dude. Oh, man. Why didn't Hillary try harder, dude? Why would she fuck up with the emails, man? Like, oh, dude. Oh, man. Aww, what do you mean he won? By how much? How much did he win? Come on, Tyler, yell at me now.
It was 213 to however much. She was down by like 60 points.
Aw, dude, no. It was supposed to be close, man. That's a blowout.
I was very hopeful. Cautiously optimistic, but I mean, we wouldn't have come here if we didn't think she was gonna win.
She's gonna put us in slavery. We about to be in chains like a motherfucker. We going back to room. Obama gave y'all hope. Trump bring it back to room.
Get your abortions now. Because we're gonna be fucked. And we're gonna have to live with it.
You're awake, by the way. you're not having a terrible, terrible dream. Also, you're not dead and you haven't gone to hell. This is your life now. This is our election now. This is us. This is our country.
Oh my God. I'm really fucking crying. Oh my God.
I saw Michael and his fiance. I could not be here with us. And I had an opportunity to serve. To introduce to you the president-elect of the United States.
You know what? One thing I am going to say after I got it together is that I am still going to support Bernie Sanders and everything that he does, because that was my number one guy to begin with. And I hope you guys, you know, I hope we all just educate ourselves even more than we ever have. And I hope that this doesn't destroy our nation.
This is an American war story, is what it is. And I laugh just because I'm so scared, honestly. I'm so terrified and sad. Half the country, millions of people, have supported someone who is openly racist and misogynistic and xenophobic. And I've actually never been so sad for our country in my whole life. And I've never been so scared. And as a person with white privilege, I can't imagine what people who don't have that privilege must be feeling.
Second on that. So I went outside to take a breather, have a beer, and now I'm back and I'm fired up. Okay. Yes, we have the internet, but it takes a significant time. Or a significant amount of time and resources to sit there and research all the issues on your own. I have no respect for women who voted for Trump, okay? I think so poorly of them, and the reason why is because, look, I don't think that you're a single issue voter. I just think you're dumb, okay? I think you're fucking dumb. I'm losing my mind tonight because of how stupid the majority of the country is.
I don't respect women, specifically who voted for a man who is going to be on trial for sexually assaulting a child, a pedophile.
Yeah.
Like, let's talk about grown-ass women. Because what did Dave Chappelle say? Well,
I think that charge just got dropped. But hey, look, man, you got to give us power, man. Without money, we don't have power. Let's just keep it real. So let's go on a bond burning tour. Red states. Let's go talk to them. Let's wake them up. Hey, in whatever language they understand, you want to get in the beginning, we'll do a little rough verbally, right? And get them a little angrier. Then they'll show up to a rally. They'll show up, right? The brakes are off, okay? So, like, hey, you know, before I'm worried about asking you guys to become members, get independent media, I'm not worried about it at all anymore. You got to join. If you don't join, how can we fight back?
Maybe Hillary Clinton could run again. It's her turn.
And so, I actually lost a train of thought for the first time in 12 hours.
You're not going to be polite, and the Democrats are...
Not every Trump supporter is a racist, but every racist is a Trump supporter.
That's right.
So here's the ones that are left undecided. Okay, right now, as we stand in the Electoral College, it's 244 to Trump and 215 to Hillary Clinton. So the ones that are left are New Hampshire, Pennsylvania, Michigan, Wisconsin, and Arizona. So out of those five, she has to win four. Okay? We broke the New York Times needle. It's just stuck at 95%. I think they felt embarrassed to go to 99% before they call it. I think that we can now declare Hillary Clinton the worst candidate in American history. The worst politician.
In our lifetime.
Certainly in our lifetime. I don't know how, you know, the guys from back in the day, Tippecanoe and Tyler Too were. But she lost to a guy named Barack Hussein Obama. She couldn't beat Donald Trump.
Jesus Christ. With everybody on her side. With everybody trying to help her. Frickin' Republicans were coming out of the woodwork to try to help her.
Even J.D. tried to help
Jay-Z,
her.
J.Z. Beyonce. For Bruce Springsteen.
The Beehive.
Everybody. Every frickin' television comedian. Everybody was on her side. Even guys like Michael Moore.
Robert De Niro.
Everybody. And she still lost to this guy. What does that tell you?
Donald Trump is president of the United States. We all want to.
Well, no, we're filming like a sci-fi movie.
It kind of feels like Machete. Remember Machete, over the top, you know, purposely over the top.
It's like a grindhouse movie.
Grindhouse.
Yeah. And so.